I get close up and intimate with a Hereford board.
I just want to change it a little bit tonight. So I'm going to do the preview of Incident Support Unit. And then after that, if you say, if you like live music, join me, Andy O'Hare, a little bit later on, where I'll be reviewing these bands. Then we do them, then you do your little spiel. So rather than me, because at the moment they've been very random, the way they just, you know, these clips have appeared. So talking a little bit about the Nosstop Festival there, well, Pete Nosworthy is the festival director of that particular event. And of course, last year the Big Chill was also cancelled, but record numbers came through the gate at Roden Paddocks near to Bromyard. So did the Big Chill cancellation actually help the Nosstop Festival?
A lot of the Hereford crowd anyway, a lot of the people who came to Big Chill travelled from London. Equally, I think it's a terrific shame that the Big Chill's not happening. It's great for the county, it's a fantastic festival and brought a lot of people into the area.
But does this mean the day of the festival is numbered?
The smaller boutique festivals that are gaining the people at the moment, and the bigger ones, apart from Glastonbury, that are losing them, yeah. I think the smaller festivals are more intimate, the atmosphere is better, they're more friendly, they're trouble-free, more family-like. And that's the sort of thing that the festival goers are looking for these days. They're looking for more than just watching bands, they're looking for total...
Well, we've been speaking to David Littlewood, who's a general manager at Eastner Castle, and he says that the estate was trying to find an event to replace the Big Chill. Well, Alison Turner got in touch on our Facebook. She says, thank God for that, I can get some sleep now that weekend. And Saf Kitty Hadley says, that's diabolical. I really, really wanted to go along to the event.
So it'll just be the later, the last one of each. There'll be a couple
okay.
of
things.
It'll just be the later one.
So, what are we using on the first?
Right, cutlers, hot knives for the later one.
Yep, got that.
Johnny Masking, just the only one.
Yeah.
Then, grabbing a break.
All sorts of publishing kind of meetings, but it's just bubble packed.
There's a chance I've mentioned it a couple of times. We'll watch the open mic night at the Firefly, and he was in the original Shaking
Tree. And the only place to be was a slap magazine Christmas party winter solstice back at the Worcester Arts Workshop. They kicked off a bit of an inspired choice. This is one of the few that I can actually play from Bradford's Captain Hot Knives. Inspired choice. Here's of course Johnny Kowalski and the Sexy Weirdos, who have got to be one of the acts for 2013. They're more Eastern European, but I like this song because it got lots of mention about pubs in Worcester like the Firefly and the Pig and Drum. Except for one, but I've got to mention, they came together with a new drummer on the night, Ed Steelfox, a great friend of this show. But there were some amazing, stunning performance, but some amazing solos, especially from Phil on bass too. But now he played a solo, a long solo, at the end of about an hour long set. And if you've seen the size of that bass tuba, where did he get the energy from?
Undercover Hippie, we were hearing one of his tracks last week, Boyfriend. He says, you may have noticed that the Undercover Hippie name is somewhat absent. That's because I'm losing that name now. I'm performing under my own name, Billy Rowan. So thanks very much for getting in touch.
bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/intro.
So we've talked all about the Running Man dance. Are you ready to dance like a robot?
Excellent. Let's go.
The guys who have checked us out and they put us on this stage. So thanks very much to them. Thanks to the two MDs. This song's the one that I hate, but they love. So this song is called the Robot Song.
So I wondered if you could give a ring to some of these. I've emailed a lot of people.
Dave, I'm really okay.
So they've confirmed. No, King Mantis, I don't know if you've got a number.
No, I don't know that.
Or Mike might have a number. Heroes of Hanoi, I've emailed them, but they haven't got back to me. Fights and Fires, they generally can't do Sundays, but I can't find a number for them, and I thought you might have. So if you're able just to do a couple of ringing, a bit of ringing around.
Yeah, okay.
House is finished.
And the balloon, that's...
Yeah, well, they're all in Morven, you see, and I earmarked them for a session ages ago, and I've got, you know, I haven't had the opportunity. Is this perfect for them? Hullabaloo, they've given me like 15,000 numbers as well.
Of course, the band machine to deliver season number Nuts for Christmas.
Brilliant!
And that's it, folks. Yes.
Wow.
Do I get PRS for that?
Yeah, you do. You get a royalty. Great, they could talk about more than rocks at the same time.
No, I'd put Heroes of Hanoi or Hullabaloo.
No, you've got Fights and Fires or Hullabaloo.
Yeah, Fights and Fires or Hullabaloo, whichever one's available. I would go with Fights and Fires first if you've got their number, because I keep promising them that.
Okay.
But definitely J. Rudy.
Okay.
Definitely Steve Gummers. Well, so, but if I can't, then
it's
point zero.
It's
five. Hullabaloo or Fights of Fires. J. Rudy, Andrew Hanoi, point zero or Steve Gummers or Dale Von Miniker. Those are the five that I'm trying to get on the lineup.
Okay, give me something to go for.
As you see, a lot of them I've emailed and they haven't got back to me.
Okay, let's see how it
goes. Andy, I think Remy Harris is at the door.
Thank you very much. This is a song called Wanting More.
Forward, obviously. Cold?
Yes. I love it when it's sunshine, I love it when it's...
All right, let's just get some volumes on you.
BBC.co.uk.
BBC introducing in Hereford.
I only just cottoned on to what you were talking about there,
O'Hare. Oh, I feel really bad at the moment. I mean, I had to bring the Remy Harris and Ben in from reception and they were practicing. Oh, I felt so bad about them. They were absolutely brilliant. That was a fantastic session, guys.
Here we go.
Oh, yes, here they are again. This is Hey You Guys, and I caught them for the second time in 2 days at the newest, one of the newest venues. It was AJ's in Hereford, which is just actually round the corner from the studios here. Now, when I saw it at the Mall, but it was whimsical and playful, is the best way to describe it. At AJ's, Hey You Guys bordered on the semi-lunatic. He's got them off to a bit of a tricky start, but he's had Pete Adams had checked out the Bronze Bowl in Hereford's High Town, and he thought they'd only had one testicle, and he had to reassure the audience that his perception that they had only one testicle didn't necessarily extend to every single Hereford male. lots of jaws flapping at knee level. The great, I think there was some steering contest, distribution of sweeties, and an invitation to sit on Santa Pete's knee. The inevitable consequences. Now, knowing how much the acts have gone down in Hereford in the past, all in all, I think it went quite well. He wasn't lynched.